Right, everyone, today we are on set with the Manchester Joyces. We've got Dougie Joyce and Dean Lynch Ward. Yes, of course. Do you know what it is? It's always that first opening, boys, I have trouble with all the time. I don't know what it is. Do you know when you introduce yourself, you go in the room, you shake hands, didn't you?
Yeah.
But you don't introduce yourself straight away. So when you then go to do something like this, you have to introduce yourself first, and then you'd be like, oh, boys, how you doing? I appreciate it, boys. I'll tell you what, it was an absolute nightmare. Getting parked around there. You boys just parked outside, that's all I for you. So I fucking hell, I parked like 15 miles down the road. Oh my god. Boys, how you doing?
Good.
Yeah?
Couldn't be better.
Oh, good. Listen, I reached out to you, Dougie. You've been an absolute legend. You messaged me back straight away. That brought us here today to do the podcast. So let's hear your story, man. Let's talk about you boys and where it all started.
What would you like to know?
Everything, mate, and everyone wants to know everything as well. You know,
whatever you ask, if we can answer it the right way, I'll answer it for you. So you got to give me, you give me the questions.
It's gonna be a long day.
Possibly give
me a long day.
It would be a long day if you go into too far.
So, what was it like growing up in the travelling community, being part of the travelling community?
Well, just rough and ready. Children, obviously, to me, normality. As a little child, you don't know no better. That's your life, and that's the way you are. You're reared up as a little boy. You're out there. Just like having a normal lifestyle, really, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah, we
great lifestyle. Free, wild,
100%.
Yeah.
Yeah. From being on the outside, looking into the travelling community, I wish I grew up a travelling way. Like truly yeah. Do. Although it's been hard growing up. We was talking about this before Dougie turned up here about growing up in, going to the Catholic schools and.
You know what it is? It's hard growing up. When you're coming from like travelling communities and Catholic families with strong backgrounds and strong views, you're raised a certain way. So for us it went hard, but from outside of looking in, it's hard.
Yeah.
Can be.
Yeah.
But I don't change a day of it the way I was raised, the way my father raised me. Probably the same with myself, because travellers will always stand proud, and it's because of where we're raised.
Yeah.
And now look at it. It's one of the black choices, don't you?
You know, the sense of humour with you boys has been absolutely amazing. It really has. So what's it like being a Joyce then? Oh, there's something that you're going to get the whole time.
Are you serious? The best thing in the world.
Yeah.
Come on. Yeah. You're looking at the main man himself, aren't you?
Well, this is it. And
you have to tell people when you see that and hear that.
Yeah. It does come across that you are the main guy of the Joyces. Yeah. How is that settling with you?
Yeah, well, so it's not easy, I'm not going to lie. A lot of responsibility. So I mean, you got to take time to look like this. So I mean, dress like this. So I mean, it takes a lot of time.
Yeah.
Only joking, by the way, before you all get there.
You have got a lot of eyes watching you, you know, looking up to you, looking to see what you're doing next. How are you managing all that lot? The fact that you are never in a shadow nowhere, you're always in the light. Because
always born, it's just the lifestyle I live. It's just, you can't pick and choose what you want to do. Well, you can, but I wouldn't change what I do. I like being active. I can't sit in the arse. I like always on the go, doing my thing. And whatever I do, it's just, it works for me.
Yeah.
I'm in the right circle, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. How does it settle in for you?
Like I say, I'm adaptable. I've had to be adaptable. Because I'm unique.
You had to be adaptable since you got the beat.
It's
never looked back since.
I'll tell you one thing, George. Sorry, but you're saying there's a lot of eyes on the spot, like with Dougie and myself. And all they want to do is see us fall.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I mean about not being able to be in the shadows. They're waiting for you.
We put the same message out there all the time. Rather than watch us fall, stand in front of them and see if you can fall against us. We always put the same message out there. Don't watch us fall. Don't be smoking mirrors and these side messages and differ for us to fall. Stand in front of us and make us fall.
Everybody can criticise. You know, it goes on and on and on and on. And we use the world trolls. I call them tramps. They are what they are. Do you know what I mean? They sit
there. Do you get a lot of it, yeah?
Oh, of course, man. But you know, you just laugh at us. If you don't laugh, you cry when you saw. What's the point getting upset? If you reply to the whole world and have a fight with everybody, then you're going to be chasing everybody, aren't you? It goes on and on.
You've got to do some rants that spoke about it. It's as simple as that. You know what I mean? So all the people, what you've got to remember is, like you, for example, we'll get slated for putting a video out there challenging people. You've got the balls to do that, what you're doing.
Yeah.
We're out there, we're active, and we're backing you.
And it's not like we've got a problem with anybody. Well, there's a few people that have got problems, and get out and face them. The thing is, we're being men about things. Whatever way you want to go, we'll happily oblige.
Yeah, and seeing you from like your social medias and things like that, you are standing tall like me. You're going in and you're fighting. You've got your fair play man. You've been a fair play man on a few fights. Yeah. You've been there too. And how you are representing yourself is pretty true to how a man should do it.
Should do it, yeah, 100%.
But everyone will sit back and agree with that.
But it's the only people that's going to say all that there is the people that's going to hide behind the computer, people that don't like you, your enemies that's going to shit talk, yeah, and people that ain't got the minerals. But you can give all the advice in the world to everybody else, stand up and fucking fight. Come out and listen to me, I'll be obliged. The same thing is, I've got a problem with anybody. People that I have got a problem with, yeah, no one's got a problem with them, and you haven't got a balls to come out.
Yeah, you ain't hiding from no one.
Hiding from fucking nobody. The way I've been reared up my life, yeah, is stand your ground and fight. Win, lose, or draw, you have more respect for being a fucking man.
So therefore, we go everywhere. Everywhere. Everyone has a problem with us. We go everywhere and don't seem to see it. You know?
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
But that's social media now, though, no?
And even on the back of social media, there's talk everywhere, there's fucking, you know, there's probably the problem with mountain bikes and cars and chalets, all the planes all over the world, they've got a problem with us. I'm not being funny there. We don't hide from nobody. We're everywhere. When I say everywhere, if there's an event, we're there. Yeah. If there's a bar, we're there. If there's anything, we're there. Yeah, so we don't hide from no one. And what you tend to find is half these people we have got a problem with, when we walk in somewhere and land on them, hey, boys, you want a drink? And we sit back by the humour, it's the same shit, different toilet. Yeah. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it's just, and it gets,
everybody's a gangster, yeah, until you're in front of them.
So you're in front of them, that's what I mean?
And oh, I say, do you know what? I've got down everywhere on my own. Sometimes I'll be with
you. You come in.
Yeah.
You was here first, you come here. Yeah. We didn't even know you was here. He had no reception on his phone, so you didn't even know.
Don't need dog strolled in. Yeah, that's what I mean. Listen, we go with everyone because I don't fear anybody. Not bothered. It's not that I'm being stupid about it and put myself in a situation. I live my life every day the way I want to live it. Not bothered about nobody, and I'll deal with something when it comes in front of me. I've got my wits about me. I'm always prepared. I'm always ready. I've got things ready around me, and whatever you want to, you know what I'm on about. But it doesn't stop me from living my life.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? The way I want to live it. I'll go happily down to the drop centre. I'll go London. I'll go Scotland. I'll go anywhere I want. Whoever's got a problem and I see them on that spot, I can use them. So I'll be happily stand there and have it. But these people that want to do these and have these plans, they're going to give it to you and say they're going to do this. And they'll sit there all drinking and all the other stuff. And yeah, and then the next morning, when they come down, oh boy, yeah, we'll do it again next time. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But they're the cowards. They're the ones that'd be afraid to see you and duck and dive you when you're driving past. I'll happily drive past, and if I see them, I'll get on another road and say, listen, come around the corner. Mm-hmm. They'll take off like a fucking shot.
Yeah. That's what you said before, when you said about, you know, you were the Manchester boys, you were myself, and you were Dougie, your man. We just make one thing clear, you know, we're all over Manchester, not a fraction of Manchester, like
something. Yeah, you're very active.
We're active. We're all over Manchester, north, south, east, and west. And we even go to Greater Manchester, bigger borders, we're everywhere. So if anyone's got a problem, we're easy to find. If he's not with me, he's on his own. If I'm not with him, I'm on my own. So we're not, you know, we don't roll in the patch and bring hyenas, no, we can do. You know, we've got that, but we don't, you know, we don't really stay that. So we're not hard to find. So when people say, when you say, what was it like growing up in Manchester, it was tough for us all. Growing up, no matter which bit of Manchester we grew up, it's tough for anyone growing up in Manchester in the generation we grew up, whether you was traveller or non-traveller or X, Y and Z. But the thing is, we still hold our own town. I'm proud to say that we're from Manchester. All the shitty asses that talk shit don't even live in Manchester. That's where the shit talk
comes. Yeah, yeah.
Or the little fraction of Manchester where they can bury under the ground.
Stop hiding in your flock of sheep and come out to a fox. Because I promise you, the first place I get the people, this goes out to exactly the people that knows exactly that I'm referring this to, the ones that's hiring and the ones getting all the shit back, yeah? I can't wait to see these boys. Can't wait to see this. Mother's life.
Coming, boys.
Trust me, can't wait. Can't wait. And I promise you, I'll do life in jail for you when we get a hold of this.
Can I come with a camera?
Huh? You can put that camera on me, don't worry. So all you got to do is smile at me.
Yeah, so you're directing that. You've got some.
No, it's just certain people, shitty arses, yeah, that's going to be sitting there watching this, yeah. And listen, you sat there, listen, what's next? And you say, okay, there's the other thing, you know, let's see what he's got to say today. I say the same thing I'll say every time. Just can't see your voice. Friends, whatever he's on, enemies.
I've got gangsters that ride mountain bikes.
You've got
gangsters that ride mountain bikes declaring war. I'm not being funny, Sean. You're on a mountain bike. Then you want a war with me, do you know what I mean? It's just bullshit. So that's why we say, you know, put the knives down, put the guns down, put the mountain bikes down, put your money down, you can have as much smoke as you want.
Yeah, do you know what it is? Those that know me and the things I do, they know that I'm massive on this whole knife crime. Like, you know, I've done my fair share of knife crime back in the day. I'm not proud of it. I do regret it.
So you've been there yourself.
I've lost my brother through knife crime. And you, when you come in, you shoot me
when I got stabbed.
Yeah. And do you know what? That song resonated with me hard, you know, and I think to myself, you boys do it right.
But you know,
there's no smoke and fucking mirrors. Like, that's straight up.
Well, listen, when I see that, when I see the
no, fiend, no, 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 no.
When I see the fiend that stabbed me, when I see the fiend that stabbed me, and I hit him head on with my hands, he's gonna know what day it is. He's gonna see every day of his life flash before him, and I'm in front of him. You know exactly who you are, and you know I'm gonna get you, because you gotta have that knife on you 24/7. But I walk with ease 24/7 of my life. Feel. So he's gonna know. Do you know what I mean? He will know.
Does he know you know who it is?
Oh, he knows me very well. He knows. But like I said, it wasn't as if I got stabbed and victimised when it happened. It was how sly it happened and so forth. But I don't really want to get into it, because there was a lot of rats around me, closer than what I thought. You know, at the end of the day, it was a stupid dinner by myself, going there and on my own and so forth. But one thing, I went there on my own, but believe me, a bullet.
Yeah.
But when you're up against a knife and you don't see it, like, you're outnumbered. Yeah, like, even the rats know. The ones that was around, the ones that you lie next to, were the rats. Do you know what I mean? It's always the one you sleep with, you find out is your worst enemy. I'm not going to get into it, but he, that little fool, knows. When I walk up with him, he's going to know what day it is. His life's going to flash before him when I'm stood in front of him banging. And he knows. You know exactly who you are.
Interesting, yeah.
Hey, get a little bit deeper. He went in, I was like, yeah, come on.
Pure silence, mate.
Now you can clearly see that your attention is...
Oh, it's quite good there.
Yeah. How did you... When this happened to him, was you too tight then?
Yeah, well, time the team that was been tight, but when that happened, obviously, shortly after that, because you had to get yourself sorted out, came and see me, that's when you come back me that time. Yeah. And since then, I've left each other's side.
Yeah, you are very close, aren't you?
Yeah. Close.
And it's not just friend. That's like that's pure love between a pair of you, like
family. We died beside each other, and
he realized who his family was, who his cousin was. Yeah, once in a while, when time come when you needed him. Yeah, and I was the only person that was there for him. I never left his side. Same with me. There's things that we've done, shared, and done together, which can't be said on camera, but that shows you the loyalty between each other.
Yeah,
goes without saying.
Yeah, you can't buy loyalty.
No. This is true. This is true, I'm a firm believer in that as well. Like, you know, once you've got someone that like that, it definitely keep them close.
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah.
But you know what life these days? You know, people say a million more things. Why can't everybody just get along? Be friends. Be happy. Be happy with what you've got. Respect your family underneath your roof, and get along and leave all the drama behind. But you always get the silly prick.
Would you be happy not to fight again? If they turned around and said you've never had a fight again, would you be happy? Because it's bred into you, right? It's your blood.
Yeah, I think anyone would, to be honest with you. But as a fighting man, you always get that itch. Yeah, and the thing is, take it to the gym. But if you got the opportunity not to have a fight again, I don't know if I really answer for you, because I don't know. It's like telling a footballer, could you never kick a football again?
You can't be. What's
spread into you? You are what you are. You're probably 60 years of age. You've probably seen in the football park. Poor boys. I'll point afterwards. Few things.
You can't change your DNA. Yeah. You stop away from it, spread into us. You know what I mean? Yeah. So if you take us out of the equation, go back our generations, it's all the way down.
Yeah.
He's got five sons. I've got no sons. He's got five. Probably two out of five. Three out of five are going to be fighting. It's naturally spread into him, whether he takes him to the gym or not. Do you understand what I mean? So you've got to ask him. It's like saying, would he be happy not fighting again? Any man would be happy not fighting again, but if the challenge in front of him, he's going to go straight out, because of the man he is.
Sometimes you always have to be there, so that's why you always have to keep yourself fit.
Yeah.
And ready. As soon as you let your guard down, in this day and age now, you let your guard down, that's it. That's when people walk over.
People are waiting for you
to fall.
To be, not you fair. Just in particular, yeah. Everybody. If they can get one up on you, they'll sit in the shadow and wait for you to be drunk. For you to like drop your key on the floor as you go into the car or something, just putting your wheelie bins out. Someone is always waiting. So because of the lifestyle you boys live within what you do with the fight and stuff, are you always aware? You must be always aware that
people call it paranoia. Yeah, I call it a healthy paranoia.
Yeah.
There's a difference.
I definitely understand the difference, you know. Like, yeah.
And the thing is, that's why it keeps me sharp. And that's why I don't get caught slipping.
Yeah, I think that'd be hard to catch you slipping.
Yeah.
I believe it'd be hard to catch you slipping because you're very alert.
Yeah, of course. I don't want to guard down or put myself in sloppy situations. I'm always going to make sure I've got my back covered, regardless where I'm dealing with. So,
you can tell alone when you came here. I was here first. And then
yeah. So, do you know what? And meeting you boys, this is the first time I've met you boys. I've spoke to you before, before we come down here. And, you know, I've watched both of you on social media.
Yeah.
And, yeah, you was really welcoming when you come in. I met you first, so you come in afterwards. But, yeah, amazing guys, like, really.
Well, don't get it twisted amongst our own. We are good people amongst our own.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we're not what people. So, obviously, people paint a picture. And let's get a message out, we're not by people.
No.
All it is, we just deal with the issues the right way.
Everyone looks at, yeah, everyone, like what Dean's saying there is 100%. People look at it like, oh, they're violent, they're this, that, and the other. But listen, anybody can be violent. Anyone can do anything. A monk can come up and fucking take you out and stab you. Do you know what I mean? Kill you. Anyone can do anything. The thing is, what I do is just protect my family. I love my mother to pieces. She's my queen. She's absolutely beautiful and the nicest woman you've ever seen in your life. My father, lovely man, quiet man, proper man, rears up well, looks after my mother. Do you know what I mean? What a man. My little baby brothers and sisters, all I do is protect what's mine underneath my roof. Apart from that, I'm not really bothered. I treat people how I want to be treated, treat with respect. Apart from that, get on with my life. That's all I'm bothered about. That's all I fight for and protect. It's always my family.
Yeah, it's good. And your sons, they're all in the fighting game as well,
they? Yeah, they are.
They've all been boxing.
Yeah,
what,
yeah.
What age did you start? You're starting off with boxing?
As soon as you start walking.
Yeah?
Yeah. I'll be asleep in bed and come up and hit me a boxing morning for the base. Wake up every morning. My auntie used to do the same thing to me. Yeah, him and Tyson. Bang, bang. Yeah, waking him up. I want to pull his little hair out. Obviously, he's got beautiful little hair. Head across. And I'd do be asleep there. And he used to come up to me. And, like, I don't know what little competition they ever seen. So I draw back. Bang. Hit me a boxing in the face. That's what I got. Well, you got to love them, right?
Definitely. Family is everything.
Yeah.
Whether you're from the travelling community or you're from, you know, what is it you called? Country.
Countryman,
yeah. Yeah, family is everything. It's just the way it is, and it has to be.
No matter what breed,
there's good and bad in everybody. At the end of the day, everyone's got different cultures. I'm not going to start getting into all everyone's cultures, what they are, what they're not, but everyone's different, but we're all human beings, aren't we?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely, yeah. Definitely.
Doesn't make anyone better than anybody else.
Yeah. Yeah. So when, after, just going back to you, after you was stabbed, was that when you were shot at the same time as well?
No. That was when I was shot before that. A couple of years before that. That was when I was younger. But when I got stabbed a few times.
Not too long ago, was it? A couple of years back?
Yeah, a few years back when I got stabbed. So when I got stabbed now, the recovery period, I hit a stage in my life where, you know, because I've never really drawn the blade to anyone else, it was kind of a shock.
Yeah.
And it was a shock to see the people close around me at that time, the way they reacted against me. They liked to chose the winning side, what they thought was the winning side. So all I'd done is I went within myself, sharpen myself up and put myself back out there.
A lot of people go the other way, and I guess having the strength of Dougie with you as
100%.
Well is, you know, not just in the fighting ability, but just having him.
He understood my journey, because there's other things I was going through, and he was going through similar things himself, so we understood the journey. And then, like I said, you know, I could have been out there rounding myself up with the numbers, because we got numbers, and gone back and put a saddle on and got down. But I thought, nah, I'll bring you to my world, because you won't survive in my world, that's the thing. You know, and I know for a fact when I polarise him, when I pummel him and put him into next week, I know I'm not going to get 30 years up my ass, because I've done it with them.
Yeah.
Do you understand what I mean? Yeah. But I know one thing is, when I've done it with them, he'll be working on like a cripple after I finish with him. And I swear that, 100%. But like I said, I did it at that spot for about 2-3 years. I was a bit within myself, but it wasn't confidence or nothing like that. It was the people I kind of looked after around me, the way they treated me afterwards. And I thought, wow, that's what got to me more. It wasn't actually being stabbed. I can say that on the chin of my man, you know what I mean? So, but I can say it stabbed on the chin. He can't say them on his chin.
Yeah. And I guess when you have a lot of people around you, it's hard to work out whether they're there because they're there for you or whether they're there just to ride the storm with you. Do you know what I mean? Like the whole...
When the storm's coming,
because you... Yeah. And you boys are like You know, especially your name, your Joyce, the Joyce name is very, very well known.
But we're active people in general, do you know?
Yeah.
Especially, I mean, he's more active than most.
But I always see you boys together.
100%.
Always see you boys together. When you're on your lives and stuff, you're there.
Constantly.
And, you know, and you have your say, you put the camera on to him, as he says.
And I'll never leave him, he'll never leave me.
Not too far, he will not be not too far.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So,
yeah.
In the radius. Within 10 minutes, no matter where we are. Do you know what I mean?
You just got to get enough from me, can't
you? Vice versa. Hey.
Sorry,
put it one way, yeah. I'm always the one who wants to go home early.
Is that just for the cover, yeah?
You get that?
So it's your fault.
Yeah.
It's all self-inflicted, mate.
Yeah. Well, that's the thing as well, what people get jealous about as well is the loyalty amongst us. You know?
Yeah, I've not said it too much.
You know what it is with what it is with me, and the same with Dougie. I wear my heart on my sleeve, so if I'm with a man, I eat with a man, I ride with a man, I'm side by side with a man. All it is unfortunate for us, we're cousins. Do you understand what I mean? So people hate on it now. You know, and they hate on it, they'll come with the smart ass little comments and whatever else. Because you know, the thing is, you'd love to ride the way we ride the people and have that loyalty amongst yourself, because they ain't got it, they hate on it.
But do you know what it is though, yeah? Do you know you deal with the whole social media aspect of like, is that real? Is that true? Are they? Or is it just that video? Well, but I'll tell you what, I turn up and that friendship is real. What you see on camera is what I'm getting there all day. You know what I'm saying? And for like those that would view these boys and think that it's just social media clout, it isn't. I've witnessed it here today. These are true.
I mean, look, if you do one or two videos on social media or you're live here and you're with someone and then you're not with them, it's constant, do you know what I mean? It's not constant because it's just how we are naturally. You know, he'll phone me and knows where I'm going. I'll meet you there in 10 minutes, vice versa.
Yeah,
do you know what I mean? It's natural. What you've got to learn is, when it's not just because it's like anything else, we're family. Do you understand what I mean?
Yeah.
And that's the thing. We've got many cousins. You know, there's probably another cousins that we've got that team up with someone else who are close, just the way we are. It's just how it is, but they're not all over the social media active. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, and the fact you are anti-weapons as well, I'm not saying that it, like, you know, at times there hasn't been anything or whatever, but you was rather yeah, usual.
Stand up
the man's way, you know, how it should have been from the old days. Listen, to the
three of us can jump out and land on an enemy.
Yeah.
Enemy or not, if he's there and he's willing to stand, one of us will step out the three. Yeah.
Listen, the whole weapon, and that's a cowardly little bastard. That's all I've got to say. A cowardly little bastard that's afraid of his own tail. That's the whole round of my life. That's it.
You're clearly insecure if you use a weapon, aren't you? It's as simple as that.
I realise that more so now than what I ever did before, do you know? Like, I just think to myself,
pumps up with steroids,
you know, what the hell was I doing back then?
Yeah.
And I can respect you boys tradition.
You see the way you've got to kind of look at where I swear by, you know, Doug is the same. We both got took to boxing gyms as kids. Not because to learn to fight, it's because we had the ability to fight. Like, so we was blessed that way. But I always say, if you're a man, our man was always put on this planet to be a fighting man, regardless of what. I mean, warriors didn't wear skirts and have tits, did they? They didn't. Did you understand what I mean? I'm just saying
that. Surprising.
I'm saying it as blunt as it is. It's a fact. So when you're a man and you're going to draw a weapon, to me, you're not a man. You might as well put a fucking scale on a pair of full of drawers and fucking run around fucking wherever you're from.
Yeah,
not like a bitch. It's as simple as that. Do you know what I mean? And that's, you know, a man's put here to do a purpose.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
So tell me this then. There's only main questions for the audience where you want to get out there to hit them. Give it to me.
Give me the question. So, you've got kids, right? How many kids you got?
Five boys, one girl.
Right, so you've had your five boys.
Yep.
Then to a travelling community, boys is like, yes, I've got my sons.
Yeah.
That's my last name, that's carrying on.
100%.
Yeah? So now you have a daughter. You have your one daughter.
One.
And how is it different on this, having a daughter to having sons?
Completely changed me. Not like completely changed me, but like changed me as the man. Of slowed me down. And she's my life. A little girl is me, one and only little girl. And I'll always keep it close to my heart. Do you know what I mean? It's completely has changed me as a man for, like, I've completely softened her. Do you know what I mean? Only softened her.
Yeah.
Because she is my world.
So I always see that. I see that on your social media. You're posting your pictures.
Yeah.
Your little comments.
She's a little diamond. She's just unbelievable. It's just, she's always everything I ever wanted.
It feels different, doesn't it?
Well, of course it does. It's a different feeling. Like, everyone kept saying the same thing to me. Cousins, friends and everything. You're not a proper man to the other girl.
Yeah.
And I used to always say to them, yeah, because he never had sons. I said, you know, I said, the man that made that saying was a man that could never have a son. Yeah. I was having a laugh, but really deep down, I wanted a little girl. So then I got the girl, I understand exactly where they're coming from, and the feeling is different.
Yeah, my daughter, she's Ella, she's my best friend, you know what I mean? Like, yeah. She's gone through thick and thin with me, got full custody of her now, it's the best thing that ever happened to me. Do you know what I mean?
Me and my daughter's my best mate.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
It's just normally like, it makes you look forward to going home, makes you look forward to like, just spending time with her, watching her grow. Like, I've never, don't get me wrong, I've experienced with all my boys, but with a little girl, you've got to be a lot more gentle.
Yeah.
You've got to be soft.
Yeah.
You've got to be a lot more things.
So that's the new you.
Yes, the new me.
That's a new, she's drawn the house out, and of course you're going to love and respect her for that. Course, you know, yeah, because a daughter can't bring out of you what a son can bring out of you.
No, my little Oceana is my life.
Mm-hmm.
Same as me boys. But the little girl is just a little girl, isn't she? She needs a father.
Yeah. And how do you like for her to view you in when you're going out to the fights now? Because she'll look at that like, no, my dad's going out to go and fight her, even though, like, you know,
don't want your little girl to see things like that. Do you know what I mean? They just want her to know as her daddy, the big bear, loving man. Do you know what I mean? Like, I'm always going to be there for her. And I don't want her to see all the nasty stuff in life. Hopefully, by that time comes, anyway, she'll never have to get to see anything like that. But I'll always be there to protect her and show her the right way.
So will she be keeping the Joyce name when she gets married?
She'll be keeping the of course she will. I'll tell you what, listen, she won't be allowed to get married until she's got 40 years of age.
Yeah.
I said, now, I said, unless he's a scientist, an astronaut. I said, he has to still get approval.
Yeah.
No, but she'll have a good life. I'll look after her the rest of my life.
So if your daughter goes to get married or in the travelling, is it the same as anyone else? Like, where if you're a father to a daughter, will they have to ask you for their hand before they ask her?
Of course they will.
And if they don't?
Well, that's another story. You get fixed like a car wheel.
Yeah, the same with the people that were my daughters too.
Yeah. I think it's essential, you know, like, you know, that's your daughter, that's your pride.
Of course, listen, that's something now that I've got, and that's going to be more.
I love that. So you started getting into businesses and that lot now.
Yep.
And you've got these new ventures going.
Yeah. I've got Clover Brand, Jab Signature, with a good friend of mine, partners with him, full partners, Johnny Hughes. Lovely man. Johnny the Batman, as he called himself. But top geezer. I've also got another brand with him, DJ Jim Ware. W. Josh Jim Ware, what's now, which he's full partners with. So there's both of ours. There's also a new thing I've got there as well, Jab Furniture. We call it Platinum Furniture. A fellow called Ashley Griffiths, he's the man behind it. He's working it all. Jab, obviously, we have a partner. We have shares in it.
Jab Security.
We've got everything coming out. There's going to be loads of things coming out. The name Jab, we're going to keep it alive. It's going to be the new tree of what we...
Like a
proper...
Where did Jab come from? Is it from the
it was fighting and stuff. It come from the man that I started the business with, the clothing.
So this all come about just after your daughter was born. Was it because of her that you decided to start doing, lay down proper businesses and start going down that route?
Like, it's just put me... it's just made me see the world in a different way, completely. Like, she's just completely just made me look at life in a completely different way.
Does she squash a lot of things that you've had on the back burner for you to...
Well, I'd normally do what I want to do now.
Yeah.
Yes, definitely.
And how do you think that will be for a lot of people who is waiting for you to react in a way that now she's here, that they might take your...
Well, all I can say to them all is just remember, I might have gone soft for her, but the beast is still in the cage. And the key is in my back pocket.
The same is, a lion doesn't lie only sleeps.
Wow.
And the thing is, it's like the crap on your life, do what we're doing. I haven't got time for anyone else's bullshit, the politics and the arguments. I've got businesses to run, little girl to look after, little boys to provide for. And that's me happy. Anyone comes in between, I'm sorry.
Yeah. And you've done some time as well.
Yep.
And you've come out on the other side, and you plan not to go back again.
Well, definitely. Jail's not, it's not a place for anybody. But it teaches you a lesson. Well, for some people, it just puts your life on hold.
Yeah, and that's the problem. The thing is, and this is the thing, when you go in jail, it doesn't, time doesn't stand still outside. Well, it might feel like it when you're inside.
Yeah, but it doesn't happen.
But outside, everything is still turning. It's still, people are still relying on you to do it.
When you come out, you think you're starting from like where you left off. So you've got to catch up on it.
That has been on. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I've also got a good chat page that I've just had a fella do for me. Ashley again. He'd be loving us out when he's going to get mentioned like that.
Right, really. Ashley, this is for you, Ashley. This is for you, Ashley.
Yeah, he's doing a page there for me, Dougie Joyce official YouTube channel. So, whoever wants to subscribe and give us a follow, good content coming very soon.
And listen, we set up a promotional company called Triple D Promotions 3D Fight Club. Bare knuckle announcement next year. Big things coming next year from that show as well. Tune into the Dougie Joyce channel and you'll see us on there, active in the ring banging.
Yeah, so you boys have been quite active when it comes to the, taking your bare fist into
combat.
Yeah, into the ring, which I think is absolutely amazing that you've took it into the ring, because you know, you've got your Fair Play men, which you've been a Fair Play man last couple of times.
Yeah, that's right.
I've seen that, and to be fair, you have been fair. You've been true to the name, Fair Play Men. You know,
keep it right from beginning to finish.
Yeah, and it truly does squash beef, doesn't it?
Of course it does. Well, what do you think of that there? That was, they don't normally do it the way I've done it. Yeah, and I thought, you know, I'm going to do it the way I think things should be done. Yeah, don't get me wrong, everyone's got their own opinions, and you want to fight around big yards or farms or whatever way they want to fight things in big open grounds. I think if two people want to get out there and they truly want to bang the shit out of each other, and they want to think it's going to, no one pussyfooting around or looking for this and looking for that, that's why I picked the 12-foot by 12-foot ring.
Yeah.
They can't run. Get in there. Have a fight, just like Decker and that Danny did.
Mate, what a fight.
Well, listen, what a fight, respect to both men. They both punched each other's fucking cunt.
Oh, God.
And it was a proper fight. There was no fakeness there. Listen, they were banging each other to take each other out.
You got to take your hat off to both men to let just get that player-wise.
Well, I think it was the best.
Oh, yeah, 100%. You can't not respect both of them guys that were in the ring that day.
You got to give credit. Our man saying, but, you know, he come all the way down to the Lions Den. We call it Lions Den. That's the platform that we've got. You also got with Danny Christie. You know, he come down with one man to the unknown, himself, in our fairness.
Yeah, but the only reason why I come, yeah, is because I spoke to Paul.
Paul Venus.
Yeah, Paul Venus. I spoke to him. I mean, Paul got on top lad.
Yeah, I
give Paul my word. Obviously, Danny Christie doesn't know me. And give Paul my word. I'm a man of my word. And I'd never break my word, because that's all I got in this world, the word in the balls.
That is something you stick
by. Yeah, I'll stick by it. And when I said to Paul, I said, speak to him. And Paul, he'll trust you. He's not going to trust me. I said, you give me your word, I'm giving you my word. And that's it. And that's exactly what happened. So Paul, obviously the only reason why Danny and Danny will tell you yourself, the only reason why it comes is because Paul gave me his word. Well, I gave Deck my word, put them both in there, let them have a fight, shook hands at the end. So I mean, it went from a 2-year war of hating each other to see a handshake at the end.
But you got to give both of them credit, because both of them come to the unknown and not from our city.
They didn't know what they were getting themselves into.
That was it.
And that was on both sides. So I was as fearless as I could be. And I didn't take no sides, didn't show any favouritism for anybody. I let them both do what they're doing, and then call it a draw at the end.
You had other boys get in contact with you to make the same thing happen again?
Yeah, I'm sure.
But a lot of it's smoke, because people will get in contact and say, I want to fight this guy, bro. We'll put it together, because you know we'll put it together. Yeah. And it's like smoke. The smoke just fizzles out, talks cheap.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? And we've had people challenge us since we've said we've got the 12-foot by 12-foot, so we've called it, let's get it on. The same again, it's like smoke, it's like people are mountain bikes and just ride away.
What we've done,
the ideal world is, if you've got a problem, look, we're not here to get clout for the straighteners and build on the back of that, because we build ourselves. But what we're saying is, because we've got that platform, boys, instead of going out and killing each other, use what we've got, utilize it in the best way, sort your problems out. You can both go and put your head on your pillow. One of you might be a bit more sore than the other, but I know you know you can wake up the next day and not look over your shoulder.
That's it.
Did you have any, you couldn't say that was fucking fake in any way whatsoever. Did you have anyone giving it, like, the whole trolling situation?
Oh, of course, you get all the time people talking shit, yeah.
Mate, that blood was real. The cuts were real.
There must have been about 30 stitches.
You know what, between them, we didn't even think it was going to go to that extent. When they went in there, then both the boys, they went hell for leather.
Oh.
You know what I mean? So they got it, and what I liked about it, and we said it afterwards, they both, if they weren't in a 12-foot by 12-foot, they might not have got it all out.
No.
Because we need each other's faces, they got it all out.
Yeah.
They got each other run off, and then just have a little time to think what you want to do. As soon as you went in there, both of them, I said, boys, I said, look, there's nowhere to run. Get in there, bang it out, and when you've had enough, you've had enough. And I could see that both of them had enough.
I think that definitely, that fight definitely opened the eyes to, like, fuck, that shit's real.
But this is how we do things as partners.
Yeah. Well, after a week, just on Facebook on Decker's page, there was over 1 million views. A million views.
I think that was all me.
Yeah.
I think that was all me in the shop. Check this out, boys. Put it on, tapping away whilst watching the fight.
Yeah.
I was like, watch this, because
it went fine.
Really entertaining. Yeah.
It was good the way it was done. And then, like, both fighters showed each other complete respect, because I told them, I said, boys, first one to foul, if it does anything dirty, I said, you're out, done. I'm not taking on the bullshit. And they both showed each other fair respect. And when I said break, he listened. He knew exactly what was going on. And that was it.
Yeah, there was a little bit at the end of that fight when they got out of the ring and there was some shouting and stuff. And I see that you turned around and said, hey, wait a minute. Who the fuck do you think you're talking
about? Yeah, that's right. Well, it was a heat of the moment thing. Obviously, he said things in, like, it was just disrespect to my place. You're in my place. I'm here showing you respect. So fucking give me the respect back. Yeah. And I didn't like, obviously, when he was saying things there. But listen, the heat of the moment thing, which you can understand, he's just got out from the fight.
He apologised.
I said, look, fair enough. I said, boys, we all say things wrong. Listen, I'd probably do the same thing. So would he, so would you. If everyone's there fighting, you're all raged up. It's the heat of the moment. The only thing I didn't like was, obviously, I'm showing respect. Show me respect back.
Yeah.
That was it.
And because they're not from that travelling world, they're in your world. They asked you.
Yeah.
You know, so the fact that they're not sticking to what the rules were laid down is thing, but fuck me, like you say, in the heat at the moment, you say what you say, you don't realise like where you're at because you just had your face punched in. Both of them had their face punched in, and it was thing. There was a point where I thought to myself, God, they're gonna get back in the ring, because when Hege was still in the ring and the other guy was outside,
I think they both kind of, there was a stage where they said they're getting back in the ring and I shouted, he's going back in. But I think that was the last bit of the rage coming out of him.
Because
remember, they had a lot of tension. Yeah. I don't know the full
ins and outs, but there's a lot of
things. Trust me, it was really...
Both men hurt each other. At one stage, Danny was on a podcast earlier tonight, and at one stage, Danny said, when he went down to one knee, he lost his eyesight in one side. And that's it. He had a few seconds, come back, and then back into it. Do you know what I mean? He recovered, he come back, and then bang, 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 and then he's giving it to him as well. And do you know what I mean? Listen, there's a proper stand-up fight.
He's detached his retina, didn't he?
Say again?
Yeah, detached retina. Detached retina.
Yeah.
Well, this is the thing, what we were saying. We've set a trend where this is how we settle things in that 12-foot by 12-foot ring. And what we've noticed is a lot of people will give it smoke. They'll give it smoke in minutes, but when it comes to see the actual vision, they're not going to come, because after seeing that fight, you know how serious it is when you're in there.
It takes a lot of balls. Because people can say what you want to say. Yeah, yeah. Listen, when you're in there, you're going nowhere.
Yeah.
So it takes a lot of balls to get in there.
Man, you see so many people that have gained reputation from snaking people, you know, drunk, getting them from behind, getting them from the side, whatever. You get a lot of that. It's like, do you know who I am? It's like, I don't think you know one until you get in that ring and you do it that way.
You've not got gloves on. So, you know, you're cracking knuckles in a 12-foot ring. The only one thing you get in a 12-foot ring, the gloves on.
Yeah.
But when you've got no gloves on in a 12-foot ring, I mean, if you watch that, you've seen the balance, you've seen what, you know, these kids were getting hit. Do you know what I mean? Well, we was even at the side of it. We're fighting them. We've had fights and we was looking at each other and you can hear these claps go out. So, no, that was a decent one. You know, and he was, you know, then.
Well, it was one to see when we went down there. I did see your man for what? 18 years?
18, yeah.
He was a 15-year-old, was it, the ring?
We seen a man down there in 18 years. He trained me and him as kids, right? And we walked in there, he's put a message up on the Facebook. It's good to see Dean and Dougie ref Dougie's first fight when he was 16 years
15,
old. We've not seen him.
Yeah, 15 on license. Yeah.
20 years we've not seen him for. We walked in there and he was in there and he was taken back to see us. He was, you know, that's the kind of respect we had. This guy trained me for.
It's the next generation, you boys.
Yeah, I was only 15 year old. I had a fight with a fella called Nick Dean. He was one of Mike Armstrong's lads, his brother, because he put the show on. So obviously I got told to fight a 17 year old man. I'm 15. He's 10 laps old like me. I'm 10 laps old. Get in the ring, the fella's called fucking Damien Salford Warrior Jeffries, flattening. Do you know what I mean? Fucking smashed them up in pieces every round, batting. And then fucking come out after the third round, done. He's hit me on a slide punch on the break, and I bit him, knocked him from the ropes. I've got the video, I'll send it over to you.
Yeah,
I knocked him out of the ring, up top of him, giving it, and it was just one of them fucking fights. I was only like that, a fucking rake. And then he said to me, he said, no way, was that you doing it? I said, yeah, I said, I got fucking stitched up, then I said, 15 year old fighter, 26 year old man. 13 last time. And
Kevin remembered that.
And he said, you know what? I said, I remember the fight because he said, I refereed that fight. I said, fucking hell. I said, well, that was you, yeah. And that was it then.
It was nice to know we walked in there, that we remembered us, because we didn't expect to see him in there.
Yeah. That was in the Labour Club, Trafford, obviously.
Yeah. Yeah. And we walked in there, and he was tucked back to see us. He was kind of like happy it was us turning up. You know, and he put, he done a nice write-up on the Facebook and that about us, how we trained us and we've grown into strong men and so forth. And like I said, you know, we put a message out there the other day, people that know us, you know what I mean? So,
real recognised, real right.
Yeah, he knows us. I mean, he knows the capabilities, and he knew, to be fair, you know, we knew what he was doing, but when we arranged this and we got it together for the fair play, when he was there, he knew by the calibre of us what was going to happen in that
ring. Yeah, yeah.
They had the mops out ready and everything.
Yeah. There was a lot of blood. You know, I see that Deck was struggling with his breathing. There's just because of that. You had it all over your trackies.
I had it in my face, the whole lot.
He goes running from his head into his mouth.
Yeah. I don't think that was coming from his mouth. That was coming from his
face. It was like, listen, it was a serious, serious gash. And I think he copped that off a full-on left hook, because he's hitting, got caught with a few straight hard rights, because he was just walking into the punch, he was just like a robot. And your man's just hitting with a fucking left hook, but full-on bang right in the forehead.
But you've got to stay there, though, to be fair.
He can take it, but he obviously didn't.
Both has a chin.
Decker has a chin like Grant. Because at the first open in that fight, if you
watch
the first
fight, you see,
what? But just hit him with a big straight right. And there is Decker.
he can definitely take it. There's no glass
draw. You know what it was? If they both men didn't draw as much blood, if the blood it was affecting both men with an eyesight, that fight would have gone on a lot longer.
Yeah, but you can say that there, but obviously the reason why it was drink, because it was they were hitting each other too powerful, two bangs and fucking, it was just.
I mean, they do some serious bombs in there, but this is the thing. You know, anyone that's got an issue, like we stated prior in the past with us, if you want the smoke, we'll give it you, but it's got to be in that ring.
Yeah,
because
we don't have to be in that exact ring, but we had a ring around Manchester somewhere. Is that
what made you start to go into now doing your own events?
To be fair, we were talking about our own events last year, but it took a while to get the pay-per-view and get the platform we've got, and now we've got the platform, it's time to execute. Do you know what I mean? So, like you're saying, we will be fighting on our own events as well.
And that definitely gave a lot of light to you to be able to do this now. Yeah, that opened people that never followed you or never knew much about it is talking about that fight.
Yeah.
And it was run through the joists.
Yeah, run through the joists, yeah. I mean, if people are going to want to fight now in the 12-foot ring, the only way they're going to do it is on the trust of him, because you know he's going to get the right.
My word is done. If I give my word, it's not going to be broken.
I've heard this.
There'd be no gangs.
And it's proven today.
Yeah.
You gave me your word, you'll be here today. You were here.
Yeah. That's it. And if they give me a word, I will never stand for something that I can't control. Because I'll never ever put myself in a situation for it not to be trusted.
Yeah.
Because once that trust is won the first time, it's gone, you never get it back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. I'm a believer.
Like I say, trust is earned, it's not bought, is it?
Nah, yeah.
Listen, it can take you 20 years to build it and take one day to lose it.
Yeah, this is true. Yeah, it's true. I get that even in my line of work with tattooing. You know, I've had to build up a name, and if there's someone, I could do something wrong with that.
You're only as good as your last handshake, aren't you?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. And you boys still do the old school way of handshakes, too.
Yeah.
I'm saying, I introduce myself with my handshake, I say goodbye with my handshake, you know, and I mean that handshake.
Yeah. I know it's not the same chain as me, haven't you?
Well, I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah. I see an old picture over there, like that. That's what attracted me to, because I was looking at your page. I was trying to figure out which one you was on it there, and I went, that chain looks familiar. Yeah, same group chain as me.
Yeah.
Do you know what you bond? Do you know what I mean? We've all got expensive watches and everything else. You can put them down, it don't mean shit. Your handshake is your bond. Your word's your bond. You know what I mean? And if your bond's broken, then there's no hope for it. Do you know what I mean? So, like saying, you can build trust, friendship, like over 20 years and lose it in 10 minutes. A day to lose it in 10 minutes. Do you know what I mean? So,
yeah, friendships are broken down from people like good friendship.
People will hate you when you know that you carry that trust. When people trust you and you carry that, people hate you for that alone.
Yeah.
Do you understand what I mean? But you can't change who you are. If you're loyal and you trust with them, you can't change yourself for being that person, but people hating you for being that person.
Yeah.
Do you understand what I mean?
Yeah, 100.
And especially in our community, mate, fucking hell. It's the trust in our community, it's like an A to Z.
So now the travelling community's gone into all the, you see Beth is fighting all over the place now as a sport. It's gone to the mainstream now, hasn't it? It's not just in a ring, in a gym, settling differences. They've actually took it to, is that, is that the Gypsy community that's created that, or is that just other people that have come in and just took it?
No, listen, from day dust, what's on, it's always been travellers setting the differences by one more. So even travellers got criticised from years ago all the way up to then, up to more or less not long ago. But now they're all wanting the travellers' ways. They're all wanting the travellers' ways because they see that no one's getting stabbed or shot. And you're going to have a few bangs, go up, home with a broken nose or a black eye. What's the worst thing happen to you? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And now everyone's wanting a piece of it because no one's dying out of us. No one's getting stabbed out of it. No one's getting shot out of us. You're having a fight and you're going home.
We're going back to sweat years.
And then you're solving a big feud between families. Because that's what it always boils down to. Everybody gets involved and someone's going to hurt him, someone's going to hurt him. But if them two men stand together like men and fight, and they give each other's word, it's put to bed. There's no point having a fight or something, put to bed.
Going back 20 years ago, we was classed as barbaric people for that one.
Mm.
And like we were stating what your manager said there.
And now
it's a fashion, do you know what I mean?
But it's come a long way.
We've only just been accepted in normal society for the way we deal with issues.
And the fact that you become not just like how people look to you in a negative way, I think, like, what do you feel with like I was talking to you earlier on about the TV shows, you know, the Big Fat Gypsy Wedding, all of that, but all of that along the way, how did that perceive you guys? Did the true really come through and be like, do you know what, that's really helped us? Or was that like,
just off of the telly, off the show, and
the ignorance, that didn't even change people's ignorance.
No, it didn't.
I think we've changed more people's ignorance over the past 12 months, with being real, than what them TV shows done. Yeah. The only people that benefit out of them TV shows was ITV or BBC. The travellers ain't going to benefit from it,
because yeah,
they're always going to have their nose looked down. There's always going to be that stigma, like other races and so forth. I'm not going to get into it. But I think when you see real, that's where people buy into it. Do you know what I mean? And like you're saying, going back to, like, now we've got a, you know, heavyweight boxer, everyone knows, that's, you know, that's a gypsy. So now he's opened the door to, you know, if you weren't for him alone, we'd still have less acceptance. But just for what he's done alone, it sets it our people.
It's changed the world, hasn't it?
It's changed in a massive way.
He doesn't get the credit that he should get. Please, just like, comparable, there's no comparison.
I mean, look,
Tyson, the man's going to fall all these back arguments on.
Tyson Fury's
been, and he doesn't get champion. The credit that he gets.
You know, he's done the same things what Muhammad Ali's done, and that's such more. Do you know, and he still won't get the credit he's getting, but for travellers, he's made it an acceptance for people. And our people and people like us, we're better.
The cycle should be allowed, it should be happening, but it's happening.
Yeah.
Every time he's been doubted, he's proved them wrong. Every time he said something, he's done it.
He's done it.
He is making record feats. So he, and
it's phenomenal.
And
it's phenomenal.
He is proving everybody wrong.
Yeah. And that's what I love.
We've gone back to what you were saying before about you're either born with it or you're not, it's in your DNA. Like, if you look at when Fury fought Wilder in the first fight, well, clearly.
Is that when Wilder had the mask was too heavy for him?
No, that was the fight. If you look in the fight before that, Tyson beat him hands down, and he was after money, was in the second fight. But that's clearly going
second
to show.
He got his pump on.
I don't know why he got the third one. Like, come the fuck on. And do you know what? Do you know what really bugged me as well? I want a body on my record.
Do you know
why
he got the third fight? Because you got to take it after Tyson, because in the third fight, Fair is a fair man. You give him his opportunity. Not once, not twice.
Listen,
three times.
I've had the trilogy. Look at him.
He's done it every time.
Even the first fight, gone.
But going back to your DNA, Tyson's DNA, you can't change it. Going into that first fight, whether he was 20% of what he was when he was in the first fight, he still would have beat man's down because.
When in the first time when he had the fight and Tyson got put down, he was like, not Tyson, because Tyson was out. He sat up like the Undertaker. I was waiting for Paul Bearer to come out of the corner. He just went like that. And then he just was on.
And then he got there, looked at it.
Yeah, that was priceless.
And then
come
back up
punching. You know what it is? Do you know what George Foreman turned around and said, you can't beat a man that's not willing to get beat?
Yeah.
So for me, you've got to give Wilder credit to go back into the second fight.
But you can't knock Wilder down. Wilder can fight as well, isn't
he? He's number two in the world for me.
There's no need for excuses.
With the excuses, I'd put him down to number four.
So that's what he was asking before. If he can make excuses, so could everyone else.
Yeah. Yeah.
When everyone gets beat, everyone's got an excuse to rank on the foot, the toe.
Yeah,
how many times David said
Oh, you remember when he goes, oh, my my
the leg was out there, wasn't it?
It was pinky. It was his little toe.
Yeah, it's pinky. Yeah,
I couldn't get the spring for the hang. You know what I mean?
You've got Tony Bell, you're beating Fairness Square.
He got beaten. There's no excuse. Yeah, but listen, he's one of them shouting out Tyson Fury the other day. What's up? Because he had a fight with his fucking mate. Was it the nightclub or not?
Yeah, but listen, he had an opportunity to fight Tyson. He had an opportunity to fight Tyson years ago. And didn't take it.
He's talking about coming out of his retirement to try and fight Tyson.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you what, David. If you want to have a fight with me. I guarantee I'll bat you up another round. I'll knock you out. But if you beat me, then you know we'll have a chat.
You've got to remember, you can't. You had the opportunity. To
listen, mate. You fucking heard it, right? If you do not take this up, in the scene.
Listen, you can't be pulling the tour.
No excuses. Don't.
You got to remember the scene, Sam. It is opportunity to fight Fiora. Yeah, and he flopped the fight, David.
Then
he wanted to bet against Fiora.
I think he's about 40.
He wanted to bet against him.
He bet
on his face. I'm not being funny. You know, Tony Bell, you smoked him both times. Like, no excuses. Tough fight. You know, and you want to go in with the elite.
Yeah, but he's fine.
Yeah,
but John Fiora put a bet on himself with David. He said, look, I'll bet you on the table. He said, my son will beat him.
Yeah.
And then he went, do you want to take the belt, David?
Even... David in his...
I don't know.
Even Haynes prime.
My stablemate beat him, Carl Thompson, so that says it all. Carl Thompson smoked him in his...
I'd love to see it. Hey, make the calls. He's not hard to get hold of. Trust me, I'm a small man in a small town that managed to get hold of him. Don't hide. This man wants
you. You've got to remember, see, Dave Dennis was a phenomenal athlete, but Carl Thompson, I trained once with Carl Thompson in them days, you know, and Carl Thompson smoked him, and he was an old man.
Yeah.
And then he built himself back up. You know, we've done great things for British boxing, David A, which he did. Do you know what I mean? But then the thing is with David A, what I've realised with David A, when, you know, he's got the cheat to say he wants to fight Fiora because it's proven his heart's gone. Now, his last fight with Tony Bell, you know, he had his Achilles, he had this and that. But, you know, there's always a saying, I've never heard David A turn around and say, I'll die in the ring. Tony Bell was willing to die in that ring, and that's why he won that fight. You know, he took a heart to him, so you can't come out of retirement and your heart will grow bigger in retirement and come back. Everyone who does a comeback, it's very rare that the cream of the crops has come back, and so you're going to call out Tyson Fury.
It's always fight him, yeah, it's always good. Whoever wants it most is going to get this. Now, David, hey, Dougie Joyce won shield. And leave the 2 hours.
He ain't joking either, man. Like, for
that's in a 12-foot ring, David. The smoke's there if you want it.
Well, that's not even getting professional as well if he wants. In a proper ring.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Somebody take this up and get it
no,
done.
No, it's not somebody, it's David A.
David A. Yeah. So if he agrees to this, it's on.
Listen, if he agrees to it, listen, on, listen, to, you know, now, listen now that we're in the conversation, on my baby's life, if he agreed to it, I would happily fight him. We'll have a 12-round bang out.
Listen, I'm going to go around 12 rounds and look at my cousin and smoke.
I'll bang three now, 3 rounds.
Going the full 12 and you say 3. Yep. Listen, put your money where your mouth is.
he won't take it because all he wants to do is fight Michael Morris, best friends, and then hold up Tyson Fury and you're born. That's it. So stay in your gym in London, you know it's good for you.
Ain't no stopping us, no, is it, boys?
I'm not stopping.
I want to see this fight.
If he wants to have a fight, I'll have a fight in 2 seconds. 1,000,000%. I signed the contract today.
And I'll do big numbers.
That'll do bigger. I'll be there front. I'll just be like this. Hey, make this happen. Get the paperwork sorted. He's already signed these 20 minutes ago. Like, I don't disbelieve that you would be well and truly ready for this.
Listen, like I said, I'm a man of my word. If he was willing to fight me, I would be happy to get in touch straight away. Well, it's never going to happen. You pull out the talk again, won't you? With your pinky. Or you want a rematch with the nightclub on. Because he was running low with the cash money.
We've got another dosser. We've got another dosser from the north of the country that comes down here on billboards and that asking, sending sneaky messages behind people's backs saying, challenge Dougie Joyce. I'm going to challenge you. Yeah, I want to punch your face in, you big useless dosser. You know exactly where I am.
What's his name?
Is it Maxwell Mad Max? You didn't think I was coming for you, did you? You fucking mum. But listen, it is what it is. If you want smoke, I'll give you smoke and I'll give 5 stone away. I'm only 78 kilos when I'll be ready for you. Give me 6 weeks and I'll be ready for you in a 12-foot ring, coming to our town with the billboards and everything else. And then challenge Dougie Joyce. He's put a challenge out there, but I'm challenging you for my cousin. I was like, if you want the smoke, come and have it. That's as simple as that. We're in Manchester. We're going nowhere. Yeah? Don't do anything sneaky. My Instagram page is open. you can message me and we'll get it on. But this ain't gonna be like that fucking, that thing that's on YouTube, you know, that white collarbone where he's doing fucking that. This is gonna be a 12-foot ring, bare knuckle, standing on banging, and we'll do it all for charity, no excuse. Like I said, I'll give 5 stone away for you because I've seen what you are one useless dosser. You know what I mean? I'm gonna show you how to look for fucking hedgehogs, prick.
Meaningful.
Yeah, it's got real. It's got real.
Fucking hell, there's been a few challenges on there already.
Even off the camera there, we can put it on the camera. This is how sneaky this little this dude is. Yeah. He sent a message there behind someone's back and he challenged Dougie Joyce. He's put a challenge out there.
Big old fat.
Yeah. This big boss, so why don't you tell to myself? This guy's a big guy, he's no excuse, you know what I mean?
Have you seen the statement fight? The video that you showed me the other day, please.
It is what it is,
I've two Teletubbies in the ring.
Yeah.
Absolutely useless.
Oh, you're not seeing one, honest to God, I swear to God, you're not seeing anything like it. And then he got 5 comments, and one of them said, don't worry about it, Max, a win's a win. Oh, mate, if you want to stand and bang in a 12-foot ring, lad, you've got no excuse with it. We ain't going nowhere. But don't send sneaky messages behind people's backs if we're not going to hear about it. At the end of the day, the challenge was put out there, yeah, for anyone that wanted it. So if you want smoke, it's there. If you don't want smoke, just keep your mouth shut, mate, and stay off your phone.
And stay in Scarborough, fat boy.
Yeah, is it Scarborough from?
Scarborough, yeah.
Yeah, and you know what I mean? Your midget got called out.
The chief really got called
out. I know, come on, mate. And if you are going to come here and do billboards, make sure you go live so you know you're here. That's it, innit?
Yeah. Do you find that a lot with when people do... when they do call you out, or they do have, say, if they end up coming into your town, because it really is, if they end up coming into your town, do you always find that they keep themselves secret until they leave?
Yeah, well, did she want Mickey Field on?
He come at 6 in the morning, yeah, when he was builders here, yeah? That'd probably happen from Manchester, putting up billboards asking about John Fiore to people and going on with himself. We put a challenge out there, didn't he? Shit. Yeah, but then obviously he's not come back and done billboards. But what I was saying the other day, we was getting jokes on it because we put a genuine challenge out there to him. Like, the joke is, if we're going to go London, not that we need to, we'd go live. He's come here, mate, and done it unknown, do you know what I mean? Hit a billboard and that, as if he's doing bits in the summertime at 6 in the morning when people are via visits that are just commuting to Manchester for work. If you want real smoke, all I've got to do is get in touch. We've got smoke there, we've proven it with your man the other day in a 12-foot ring. If you want the smoke, they're going to get smoke. There's no point chasing this and chasing that. What they're doing is chasing the Fiore in, because they think they'll get big numbers and they'll do this and that. You'll get numbers with us because we're out there. So there's no excuse. We're
probably
not different from
anyone. We've got extra customers now in his car wash, haven't
we? Yeah, extra customers in his car wash. What's he going to do if he decides to land on there with a 12-foot ring and he turns up in the morning to open his car wash and I'm stuck there like that waiting for him? Because it can happen, you know what I mean? It is what it is.
Yeah, I believe you boys can make anything happen, to be fair.
We've made a lot of things happen and people know that, do you know what I mean? And this is
one thing about us anyway, listen, and all that's all fun and games. We'll stand by what we say.
100%.
We'll say something if we can't back it up. Facts.
Listen, if I come back up, he won't be with me. If he come back up, he'll be around his family or not.
Yeah.
It is what it is. We don't go around there putting ourselves out there as big fighting people because we're no different from anyone else. We just do what we do.
But the point is, we're in it for the crack.
We're in it for the crack. But the point is, the reason this challenge has been put out there because the kid's done it slyly. Yeah, the fiend's gone out there and done a sly remark. Why don't you challenge Dougie Joyce? Because he put a challenge out there. Why don't you challenge Dougie Joyce? Because he did put a challenge out there. I'll come back to me. It's not a problem. Because you know that we'll give you serious smoke, and that's what they don't want. This ain't going to be fucking 10, 12 ounce gloves on for charity, white collar shit. It'll be charity, yeah, but it's bare knuckles, stand on bottom.
Hard knuckles straight off the side of the ring.
100%, mate. Let's see what he's got. I swear, see that body, that belly of yours, mate. I swear, I'll rip a lot. 100%, boom, boom, boom. We live for this shit.
Daily. Yeah. Daily. It's been brilliant, lads. Like, really, I've really enjoyed myself today.
No, but it's been a pleasure with yourself as well. Yeah. And, you know what I mean? You too.
No, it's nice to meet you, mate.
Really, I thank you guys so much. Like,
hope you've enjoyed it, man.
Enjoyed it. I loved it. I can't wait for coming down to watch the your events as well. We'll be down for
lucky March. March will be the first one. So if that Dosser wants it from Scarborough, you've got till March to get rid of it. Don't worry about losing weight. The bigger you are, the better it is for me.
So your event is going to be a beef settling event, is it? Or is it just anyone?
I don't want to jump into the old undercards, but it's also for beef settling, as you say.
Beef settlement, it's going to be pay-per-viewed. It's a proper platform. You know, we've got medics.
It'll be well organised.
Well organised. You know, we've got everything there. It's going to be it's an event. It's not no barn fighting or where or stuff. You know, it is proper. You know, it's going to be done over rounds.
Yeah, tables,
bar, a lot there. Well, I'll put the first one on in March. So if anyone's got beef and they want to get in touch and they want to do it, you know, we'll do the beef events and we'll give you these to charities or anything like that. If there's any young kids out there, you know, they're at the age enough to get in the ring and they want to settle any disputes instead of running around the streets with knives and playing cowboys and Indians. Get in touch and we'll make sure you get the best of fair play, and we'll also try and make sure, try our hardest to make sure your disputes are squashed.
Yeah.
Because the last thing we want to see is kids killing kids on the streets. There's too much of it. 100%. Yeah. So,
well, it stands as well. It stands.
David A, if you're serious, you want to take up the offer, I'll have a few of
I say it every single time and I mean it 100% on my mommy's grave. No guns, no knives, hand-to-hand combat is the best way forward to settle any dispute.
Yeah, 100%, 100%. But hey, don't fuck about, mate, he's serious. Get in contact. You can get in contact with me, I'll just pass you on to him. But you can contact him, he will contact you back straight away. He's put the challenge out on the table. 12 rounds, he's up for it, and he's going to smash your face in.
Doesn't have to be bare knuckle, we'll do it properly. Boxing gloves on, in the ring, professional.
But my way has to be bare knuckle because of years of boarding gloves and board now.
Love it. Guys, thank you again. Really appreciate it. I can't wait for the hay fight. I can't wait for the event you've got going on.
They'll never have a good day.
Yeah. Well, fingers crossed, man.
Yeah.
Listen, he's calling you out. You've got to accept it.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, he's calling you out. Just fucking get in contact, fucking.